Tonight at 6, we have some breaking news. All Boeing 737 MAX 8 and 9 planes grounded by President Trump. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Dennis House.
And I'm Denise DeCenzo. Mr. Trump announced the move just days after the deadly Ethiopian Airlines crash and 5 months after the horrific crash in Indonesia.
Three airlines, American, Southwest, and United, all use those planes. Channel 3's Roger Susannon is live at Bradley now with more on how this decision could impact travelers. Roger.
Well, Dennis and Denise, I can tell you that every traveler that we've spoken with today is closely monitoring this situation, and most feel that today's decision is the right call. Better safe than sorry. Now, CEO of Boeing is adamant that his planes, the MAX 737 planes, are completely safe, but he supports today's decision to ground all of the aircraft out of an abundance of caution so that travelers will have peace of mind. On Sunday in Ethiopia, a 737 MAX 8 plane crashed, killing more than 150 passengers, including 8 Americans. And that tragedy came just 5 months after a crash involving the same type of jet in Indonesia. The United States' decision to ground all Boeing 737 MAX 8 and 9 planes comes after other nations, including Britain, banned the MAX fleet from its airspace. Earlier this week, several congressional leaders, including Connecticut Senator Richard Blumenthal, called for the FAA to ground the aircrafts. And earlier today, Canadian leaders made the move, citing new but unspecified information. President Trump praised Boeing as an incredible company today, but says the decision is necessary to protect the flying public. Both the president and travelers that we spoke with feel it's best to proceed with extreme caution.
This, the safety of the American people and all people is our paramount concern.
I feel that they shouldn't allow them to fly anymore until they figure out where the problem is and correct it. It should be corrected.
Now, a Bradley spokesperson tells me that no MAX planes are based here at this airport, but they do have some that fly in and out occasionally, so they are certainly monitoring this situation closely. Reporting live at Bradley International Airport, I'm Roger Susannon, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Okay, Roger.